Before we actually get into the meat of the work, which is going through and removing or adding in variables to see the relationship to the dependent variable, we need to actually look and see what those components of the OLS table are. There's a couple ways to run this, and this is again explained in the lab, but I'll do it real quick. You can go to the ARC toolbox, go to spatial statistics tools, modeling spatial relationships, and then click on the ordinary least square script. The inputs for this tool are all provided in the lab, so just follow that. You can also just search for it. Go to search, put ordinary least squares, and it'll come up here. I've already run it. Once you run it, you can view the results by going to the geoprocessing tab here and going to results, and this window pops up. So I've already run it once. What we're going to do is we're going to look at the table. Well, if you go to the messages drop down here, you'll see that. Oh, look at that. That's our table, but it's not a straight line. So we need to make it look a little bit easier. And you probably already saw this in Tanya's previous video, but you just right-click here, click on View, and there you go. There's your table right there. And this is what we're going to be looking at. What we'll do is we'll go over and look at which columns and diagnostics are important for what you're going to be doing. First one is probability. In this case, normally in statistics, a confidence interval of 95% or a probability, a p-value of 0.05, is considered statistically significant. It'll also be considered statistically significant here in the table itself. You'll see a little star like you see down here. In our case, we're going to consider statistically significant to be 0.4, so a 60% confidence interval, which is fine considering that this is the reason why certain dependent variables may occur is multiple variables could have a role. There is no one that will explain the dependent variable. So again, 0.4 is what we're looking for. Variance influence factor, VIF. This column here is the next one you're going to be looking at. And what this basically is talking about is redundancy among variables. And the lower the value, the better. So these ones with greater than 1,000 means these variables are considered redundant with some other variable. So there's multicollinearity between this variable and some other variable. The next one is a coefficient. Remember, this is that beta value in the y equals alpha plus beta x plus error. This is a variable that is going to be, again, describing the slope of this line. We're looking at the sign to tell us what sort of relationship it is, but also more importantly, the number. The higher the number, remember, if this number is closer to zero, the less there is likely a relationship between the independent variable and the dependent variable. So then we have the R squared. The adjusted R squared is probably the more important one we want to look at. We want this to be as high as possible. This is a percentage of how much these independent variables explain the relationship with the dependent variable. And the higher it is, the better. The Jacques-Bert statistic, we also want this to be high. If this is a statistically significant value, so 0.05, then that means that our model is biased. There is something in there that's causing this model to be extremely biased towards one way or the other. Again, these are parts of a whole. No one thing is going to guarantee that your model is the best fit. It's all got to work together. Just because one or two variables looks good doesn't mean the whole thing is good. You got to look at it as a whole, and we'll do that.